itself in form of a complex business issues. So what does this mean? It means that case study will be jam-packed with lots of business issues, ranging from financial issues, internal business operation issues, external issues, manufacturing issues, and so much issues like that that you need to understand before you can come up with a very good report. Now, the other thing you need to understand is that you need to have this ability to analyze both financial and non-financial data. I'm sure that you know what financial data is, but the other aspect is the non-financial data. What are the examples of non-financial data? One of it is market reports, demographic reports, environmental reports. All of these reports does not have any figures in them, but you need to be able to understand or interpret this figure in order to come up with a very good report in ICANN case study. Now, what one other thing you need to know, you need to have that skill to make conclusions. We'll be doing more of these things because conclusions and recommendations in ICANN case study, they are very, very important. They are very, very important. So we need to do more of making conclusions and recommendations. Now, the other thing you need to do is that you need to understand businesses. You need to be able to understand businesses, business operations, how businesses are being done in whatever way you are being presented with a case. So these are the things I want you to focus on right now. I want you to focus on this thing, and in any case, this will help you to understand ICANN case study the more, and will help you in getting the whole idea. Then, when you are able to do this, you can pass ICANN case study easily. Thank you for your time today. See you in the next episode.